Welcome to a special best show. I recently received an email from someone asking me to review a wedding veil. I wasn't sure why, because I've said some pretty hostile things towards marriage on my site, so I wrote her back and I told her, of course I will. I even offered to model it for her. But to make sure the veil's worthy of my endorsement, I put it through some rigorous testing. Here are the five categories I tested. The first test is water, to see how well the veil repels liquid, such as spunk, tears, or saliva, in case the bride drools on herself. The second test is fire. What if the flower girl catches on fire and someone decides to put her out with the bride's face? Will this veil protect her? Next is the electricity test. Does the veil conduct 10.8 million volts of electricity? The answer may shock you. Then it's on to the urine test. I pee on the wedding veil with my dick to see if piss stains it. And finally comes the explosive test, where I detonate the veil with high-powered explosives. First up is water. I sprayed the veil with a hose and it seemed to absorb most of it. This can actually be a good thing, because in a real-world scenario, those drops of water could be tears of regret, which would be hilarious. On the downside, the comb on the veil got rusty after it dried. Yeah, I wasn't expecting that one either. Next is the fire test. I put a flame to the veil and it burned instantly. This veil is extremely flammable, so if you're looking for a veil that will melt to your face, look no further. The flame did leave a big hole in the side of the veil, though. I think this is a plus because it's convenient if you want to rub aloe on your burn scars. Then came the shock test. I decided to use a taser rated for 10.8 million volts. As you would expect, the properties of non-conducting polymers found in women's wedding fabric hasn't changed, and the veil didn't conduct any electricity. However, the veil did suffer from a few small holes during the test. Next up is the urine test. I drank a couple of beers and shotgunned a bottle of water. Then I gave the veil the most golden of showers. You can tell that I have a nutritional surplus because my pee is bright yellow. Despite giving it a thorough drenching, my piss didn't stain the veil. Which leads us to the next test. I put the veil on a concrete block for detonation.
This is the fifth and final test, the explosive test. Now, if the wedding veil survives the explosion, let's see. Receive the coveted Maddox endorsement.
The veil was almost completely destroyed by the blast, which unfortunately forces me to withdraw my endorsement. On the other hand, the concrete block beneath the veil was barely scathed, so my official endorsement goes to the concrete block. It's much stronger, can withstand explosion, fire, shock, and urine. It's the perfect wedding veil. Don't send me promo spam.